The worst part was I was sitting on the ledge, on the window ledge. I was thinking, should I just jump? Because don't want to be a burden to my husband. And then all the burden of the house is on me, because HDB is coming after me. They say you have to downgrade and things like that. So it's a very long fight with them. But at that moment when I want to jump, I hear a small little voice and tell me, why do you want to jump? It's something temporary. Hi, my name is Coco. I'm 43. I'm a retiree at the moment. In the morning, my husband will wake up about 2 to 3 a.m. I will wake up about 5. Then I'll spend time talking to him, asking him, okay, what do you want to eat for the day? Then I will get ready to cook. So I'll prepare the ingredient, put aside for them to defrost. Because for dialysis patients, we have to make sure certain things have to be soaked in the water for at least 1 hour to 2 hours. So about 7 o'clock, then I'll start cooking. By the time I finish cooking, it will be about 8 or 9. I'll prepare breakfast and the whole day meal. I always cook more, so he will invite his other friend. My husband has a medical condition called schizophrenia, so most of his friends are all the friends from the IMH side. About 9 years ago, in June 2012, I'm working as a full-time preschool principal. We went to this Marine Barrage to fly kite. So I have some kite wound on my hand because of the string. And then I just put blister, I didn't think about it. When we came back, it's for the June school holiday. So we have a 2-day, one night camp. My boss, he went to Indonesia for a fishing trip. And he came back with a big stingray. So he told me to prepare for the teacher for barbecue. My auntie cook already left for the day. So it's something unexpected, so I took over. Even though I didn't use glove, two plastic glove, because I couldn't find the rubber glove, the thing pierced through because it's still sharp. And that very night, after I did everything for the student, I didn't eat. At night, I started having a fever. The fever didn't go away for 5 days. Immediately, they took me into the ER. By the time I wake up, they told me I have a heart failure. At that time, I didn't know it was the stingray. They said I was affected by a viral infection. They also warned me that because of heart failure, my other organ might start shutting down. And that started to happen. In less than 6 years, they already find that my kidney function last year went down to only 9%. So they tell me you have to start dialysis. So Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday, I had to go for dialysis. So by 11 o'clock, my medical escort will come and fetch me. Then from here to my private dialysis is about 5 bus stops away. Here in the private center, they do allow you to bring food to eat. So I will bring along my brunch. After that, the next 2 hours, I'll just put on the headset and listen to music or do my own email or whatever. So by 4 o'clock, the machine beep. My medical escort will come at 4:10 and he will send me back. By 4:30, I'll be home. I will come into the room and sit down, rest a while. I will tell my husband, let's get ready for dinner. So we will take out the dinner and then put on the table. Like today we have rice and the lotus soup. And then while we are eating, we will talk about our day. So now I'm telling him today what happened and then how much water I take out and things like that. It was very tough for me because I'm the sole breadwinner of the house. I had to go through the 5 stages of grief because I was in denial. I kept on thinking I can go back and work. Where I have to accept that my friends of my age are all moving on. And then all the burden of the house is on me because HDB is coming after me. They say you have to downgrade and things like that. And then when I go to ComCare for help, when I put down my pride, I would say that a lot of paperwork. Which is already when I'm sick, I don't have time for all that. The worst part was I was sitting on the ledge, thinking, should I just jump? Because I don't want to be a burden to my husband. But at that moment, when I want to jump, I hear a small little voice and tell me, why do you want to jump? It's something temporary. You know, it's like, well, do you want to jump because of that? Then I realized, yeah, not worth it. If I jump, who is going to take care of my big baby? So I had to live for him. I had to live as long as I can. And then that's when I decided to turn over and listen to the doctor. And also I met good friends who gave me a lot of moral support. Sometimes God put you through certain things in order for you to understand, and one day you'll be able to help people who are in your shoes. I realized what I went through, asking for help from different departments, learning how to ask for funding and all that. Now I become quite good in it, and now I'm teaching other patients who just fallen sick. I tell them, you can look for funding from where, from where, from where. I will say that life will not be easy, but it is not every day raining, there will be sunny day. So try to make your sunny day as many as possible, because it starts with you. And then when you have negative thoughts, try to do something good so it can bring back your positive feelings again. Yeah, like yesterday I have a hard day. At night I try to do something. I found a family who need a big size wheelchair, and I lied to the social worker. And today my volunteer helped me to bring it to her. Yeah, so at least to me, it's like, as long as I can live one more day, do one more good deed, I don't need them to pay me back. But I'm just happy that I'm helping people while I'm still alive.